This exhibition, Assemblage, features artworks from the Curtin University Art Collection that are rarely seen because of their fragile, complex or ephemeral nature. The exhibition showcases paintings, collage, mixed media and sculptural works that are linked by a use of found or appropriated materials and an experimental or playful approach to art making. This artwork by Colin Lansley for me is the centrepiece for the Assemblage exhibition, and that's really because it's such an enthusiastic and exuberant example of collage and assemblage. Colin Lansley was a contemporary and friend of Robert Klippel, and together in the 1960s they raided the abandoned offices of a Sydney engineering company and took away literally van loads of wooden patterns that they would use in their work for many years to come. In the 1960s, Colin Lansley started to play around with a picture plane in which he moved away from a flat surface onto which objects were applied or placed in front of, and began to actually change the structure of the canvas itself. So he created forms out of wood that he would stretch the canvas over, and you can see that here in this artwork. This is how he created those undulating forms and surfaces. The thing that I absolutely love about this artwork is it's so kind of chaotic and anarchic on the surface, but the rear of the artwork is incredibly meticulously and fastidiously crafted. We had the artwork conserved in the lead up to this exhibition, and that gave us the opportunity to really get up close to the back of the artwork and see the structures that Colin created, which was really quite fascinating. These artist books are by local artist Janis Nadila. He was born to Latvian parents, and in fact the texts that he's used here are Latvian texts which were previously owned by his parents. So Janis has used artist books throughout his career as an artist. In fact, when he was in high school he began playing around with books, blacking out words, writing in between the text and using colour codes in different sections of the book. He's been very interested in code throughout his career, and he created a series of works titled Enigma from 1996 to 2002. And there are a series of works in there where he's used nails perforating a canvas in a very precise and ordered pattern. And he's used the same pattern here in this 2006 work. Both of these works use a kind of code. We don't know what that is, the artist hasn't revealed that, but we know that it's determined by text or words. And so that reveals the process, the formation and structure and use of colour in the nails in both of these works. This artwork is by Elwyn Lynn, who was a really important figure in Australian art in the 20th century, not just as a painter but also as an art critic and curator. He really built the international collection at what is now the Museum of Contemporary Art in Sydney. Elwyn Lynn was a matter painter, and so he was really interested in the texture of a surface and building up that surface by using things like sand, plaster, cement, and mixing that in with a really thick impasto paint. He grew up in rural New South Wales in what was really quite a harsh environment, and that kind of desolate landscape really informed his paintings over the course of his career. This artwork is by Lorraine Connelly-Northey, who grew up on a farm in the Swan Hill region of Victoria. Her father was descended from Irish farmers and her mother is a Wiradjuri woman. The artist was really interested in Wiradjuri culture and started investigating weaving techniques and other traditions, and she really wanted to start using those types of techniques, but she didn't want to use the native bushes and grasses in her area because they weren't her mother's country, they weren't Wiradjuri. So instead she started to find the refuse of the farming industry, pieces of metal and rusted wire, and to make objects out of these recycled elements. This work is called Opossum Cloak, and it obviously refers to the pelt skins worn by Aboriginal people in the colder climates of the southern areas of Australia. These were really important objects and they were made by lots and lots of pelts, so maybe 20, 40 or 60 pelts all sewn together. They had fur on one side, and on the skin side, the people would actually incise beautiful designs and patterns, and these were unique to each family and group, so people could actually determine where someone was from and what family they belonged to by looking at the patterns on their cloaks. The cloaks were replaced by blankets from the early 1800s, and this really had a detrimental impact on people's health and particularly their respiratory systems, because of course they weren't waterproof, which the pelts had been. This work, I think, really shows strength and resilience, but there's also that underlying sadness that comes with Aboriginal experience after white settlement. I've seen videos of the artist actually making some of her artworks, and I'm amazed at how strong her hands must be. She manipulates materials as if they're soft cloth, and she also uses her whole body, so it's really quite a physical process.